Here's an interesting thought. What if you could use your phone by squeezing it? We've all used a touchscreen. For the most part, we've all dialed a phone number, searched the web, or taken a photo with a smartphone. Sometimes we might command our phones by talking to them. But for the most part, beyond tapping your phone's screen, there aren't a whole lot of ways to interact with it. At least there weren't before Michigan computer science engineers came up with what they're calling Force Phone. It's software that can be installed on any smartphone, and it lets users command their phones with force and pressure. In this case, it's not just the screen that registers the force. The phone's body does too. Force Phone works by using hardware that all phones already have, a microphone and a speaker. The software makes the phone's speaker send out a tone that's inaudible to the human ear, but the mic can still pick it up. Whenever a user presses on the screen or squeezes the phone's body, those actions change the sound. These changes in tone are then translated into commands for the phone.
iPhone 6s is the only phone has this force-sensitive touchscreen, and that's the only one. Even their latest model, the cheaper iPhone, don't have it due to the cost consideration, and the Android phone don't have it either. And no phone on the market right now can let you control a phone by just squeeze it.
There's a broad range of applications for the Force Phone technology. Take, for instance, gripping the phone to go back a page, and implementing a right-click style force input that displays additional functions. Or what if you could dial 911 by squeezing the phone in a certain sequence? Those are some of the researchers' initial ideas.
You don't need a specialized touchscreen or any special sensor to get this functionality. By using the speaker and the microphone, we have developed a way to bring this technology to any smartphone through just a software.
We use our smartphones for so many tasks these days. It makes sense that we expand the language through which we can communicate with them.
My name is Atul Prakash. I'm a professor in electrical engineering and computer science at the University of Michigan. We are going to be showing you how a hacker can open your front door.